So you want to start a YouTube channel. In fact, you want to start a YouTube cash cow channel where you're not going to show your face, or you want to outsource the entire process. However, one problem: which niche should you go with? In today's video, I'm going to do a 10-minute YouTube cash cow niche challenge. So basically what that means is that I'm going to try and find a brand new niche within 10 minutes that I could then potentially use to build a YouTube cash cow business. Let's get into that. So choosing your niche is one of the most important things about your entire YouTube channel. So a lot of people will say, don't choose a niche, you are your niche. However, that only applies to a couple of people. In this case, that would be people like David Dobrik, Mr. Beast, just very big people that are kind of like bigger than the actual platform. They don't need the actual stats, the data, none of that. They're bigger than the platforms and they can do pretty much whatever they want. However, if you are just a guy like me that's trying to grow his channel, you definitely need one niche or some kind of topic that you make videos about. Now, this is where the problem comes in. There are a lot of people on YouTube already. So a lot of times when you find a niche, you think it's going to be saturated, meaning that you cannot grow within it or you're just going to fail. However, is that actually true and what can you do about it? The goal of this video is to show you guys that you can always find a new niche or a niche where you can actually succeed and make money, grow a good channel, and then grow your business. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set a timer on this phone for 10 minutes. I'm going to do research on YouTube. I don't have any preparations for this. I'm literally going to go on YouTube and try and find a niche to prove to you guys that it's always possible to do this. I'm going to show you the live results so you can take a look over my shoulder to figure out how I'm doing this so that you can also do this yourself. And there we go. Challenge started. So what we're going to do, we're going to go to YouTube. The first thing that I'm going to do to figure out a niche is use the YouTube search bar. The second thing is open a new private window, because as you guys know, if you go to a private window, you'll get to see videos that are on the homepage, the actual homepage of YouTube when you're not signed in. So this is a really good way to find potential viral niches that you can use. We can see a lot of music stuff showing up. We've got a football niche right there. We've got Nerf, we've got piano, we've got like a story type of niche. So this is a very good way to find new content types. That's one method I recommend using when you're trying to find a new niche. Go into a private window, open YouTube, and figure out what kind of content is on here. So just by scrolling, I'm not able to find a really like popping niche as of right now, or like a video which then turns into a niche. So what I'm going to do is simply go back to YouTube and I'm going to use YouTube search. So what I can do is simply type in any letter and you'll then see a couple of results coming up. So for example, if I would type in, let's say digital or whatever I would type in, I can see a lot of this stuff showing up. Now I always use these to simply come up with ideas, or I'm going to search for one of them and going from there, I'll find the search results and then go from there. So it's kind of like this rabbit hole that you end up in. And by doing so, you can find a lot of interesting stuff. So what I'm going to do right now is simply type in make money. So I just typed in make money and I'm going to scroll through the results. So we've got this guy, then we've got this guy, we've got an artist, not sure why he's showing up. But what I'm going to do is simply scroll through these and figure out if there's some type of video idea or niche that I want to get into. Of course, the make money online niche is already out there. I know about the niche, I've been in it. However, I'm not looking to get into that niche again. However, right there, I see a pretty interesting one. So it's going to be for you, the YouTube CPM by country 2021 by Creative Edutech. So I'm going to click on the channel. So what I always do, I search for anything, I analyze the results, and then I simply browse from there. So there's no like specific way to find a new niche. I've got 7 minutes left, by the way, guys, as you can see. However, I'm pretty confident that I'm going to find a good one. So what I always do, I search for a keyword like make money. I then filter through the results and then start going from there. So I ended up on this channel. What I'm going to do is filter by the most popular to figure out if that video that I found, the YouTube CPM by country, is actually outperforming his other videos. And as you guys can see, it actually is. It's uploaded 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago, and it's on 1.3k views, while all of his other ones are months old, like 8 months, 6 months, 6 months, 7 months, and all of them have similar views. So this one is the popular one, 8 months, 2.3k. Now this one right there, 1.3k in just 2 weeks, that proves that this video right there is outperforming for his channel. Now that also means that it's a good topic. However, finding a good topic doesn't mean that I found a good niche. However, potentially it's going to be a good niche. So what I would do next is simply click on the video, figure out if it's monetized, and in this case it's monetized. If it's not monetized or you don't get an ad, always think about whether you can find a concept to turn it into a video that you can monetize. However, you can see this guy has ads on the video, which is a good thing. I'm gonna click skip ads and I'm simply gonna watch the video to figure out what he's doing. So let me just turn that down a bit. So you can see that he's simply gonna use, okay, let me just mute that. So it turns out that there's no voiceover, which is a like not a good thing or a bad thing. But for me personally, it's a good thing because if I wanna jump into that niche and my competitor is not using a voiceover, I can easily make better content by simply doing a voiceover on these videos. So that's a good thing. However, as you guys can see, all this guy is doing is that he's simply screen recording, browsing through his YouTube CPM and making a video about it. So he simply went to Geography on his YouTube studio and then he's pretty much taking a look at the CPM. That's interesting. However, in my opinion, it's not that interesting if you simply screen record it with music. However, it still managed to get 1.3k views. So that is interesting, guys. I feel like I already found a good niche that I want to get into or that I could potentially get into. Now, like I said, I haven't done any research before this. Of course, I knew that YouTube CPMs were a good topic. However, judging by this, this might be a good niche in general. So what I could do now is simply take that keyword, so as YouTube CPM by country, and then search for it. And then I'm gonna figure out whether there's a potential channel niche in here. So things I'm looking for when trying to find a new niche is scalability. So how many views can I actually get the CPM on these videos? Because you can get a million views on step one, but if it has a $1 RPM, that's gonna make you 1K. Now, if you can get 200K potential views, but the CPM is $10, or the RPM I should say, you're gonna make 2K. So that's step two. So scalability, CPM, and then next up is how saturated is the niche. Now, before that, I do want to say a niche, it's like it's never too late to get into a niche. If you provide good content, you always grow. If you use the right strategy, you always grow. However, it's really important that you choose a niche where it's also kind of easy to grow. Like, don't make it impossible for yourself. So let's test these three things. So we can see in terms of scalability, the views aren't great. However, right there, 82K views, but most other videos for that specific keyword have about maybe like a couple K views. So this guy, 3.6K, what I would then do is click on his channel and then figure out if he has more videos like that. So I'm gonna click search, type in CPM. There we go. I see, nope, how much? Okay, so this video right there, 57K views, and you can see that the title is how much YouTube pays per view in every country. Now that's not the exact keyword phrase that I searched for, but it's kind of like the same topic because he's still showing how much money YouTube is paying per country. So that is still pretty much about the YouTube CPM. So what I would do next, so this specific keyword or like this topic would definitely be qualified for like to be a good video topic. However, I want to figure out if the niche is actually good. So what I would do next is simply type in YouTube CPM and find out how many specific predictions are going to show up. So we've got YouTube CPM explained, YouTube CPM rates by country, YouTube CPM decrease, YouTube CPM by country 2021. So we've got all of these search terms that are implying that YouTube CPM is actually a pretty good niche to get into. So I've got 2 minutes left on the timer, guys. However, I'm pretty sure that I already found my niche at the first attempt, which is pretty cool. But what you should do now is figure out if there are enough video topics to make videos about. Because if you go within a niche where you can only make 10 videos and then you're done, That's not going to be good. You want to make sure that there's enough topic to talk about. Now you can see that in this case, there are a lot of people simply making videos about the YouTube CPM. So just showing their CPMs, what I'm doing as well on this channel. And then we've got a few other guys showing the most profitable categories on YouTube. This is Marcus, which is actually a friend of mine, which is kind of funny that he's showing up there. However, if I keep scrolling, you'll see that there are indeed a pretty like decent amount of topics that you can make videos about. So judging from this, I'm pretty sure that I found a niche that I could get into, which is the YouTube CPM niche. Now, what I would do is make videos about what kind of CPMs are out there in the first place, then the highest CPM topics, then you can also do how much money certain YouTubers make and break down their CPM. Then you've got CPMs by country. Then if I just click on this again, I kind of forgot. You can see, you can even break this down step by step with a country. So you could do YouTube CPM in India, YouTube CPM in the United States, YouTube CPM in the UK, YouTube CPM in Australia, and you can keep that going. So right there, you already have a video like format, a video series that you can pretty much create unlimited content with, which is awesome. So that is pretty much the niche that I just found, which is awesome, pretty cool. Now I've got about 16 seconds left on the timer. So within these 10 minutes, I actually managed to find a good YouTube niche. And I actually managed to research in the first place and actually figure out that it's a good niche, which is awesome. So we've got 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and there we go. So this actually worked, guys. So within 10 minutes, I was able to find this niche. But who am I to say that this is a good niche? Please let me know in the comment section down below if you would like me to create a channel within this niche and build it up on a video. So actually document it and then actually show you guys what kind of videos I'm making, how the channel is growing, and all of that good stuff. Please let me know and I'll probably get to it if you guys want to see it. So yeah, let me know in the comment section down below. Also, let me know by leaving a like on this video that you're watching right now. If we can get 100 likes, I'll definitely do this. So leave a like and I'll get into it. Subscribe if you want to see more. Join our Facebook group. I'll leave a link to it in the description down below. And then I'll see you there. Have a good day.